has shifted. The world is accelerating. How does a country like Nigeria withstand tectonic shifts all around it? How does a society thrive with its economy, security, and lifestyle under constant disruption? How rapid do we have to act in a world where information is moving at the speed of light? As Nigeria's foremost economic think tank and policy advocacy organization, we have over the years made it our mandate to understand the complexities and champion the reform of the Nigerian economy. We are the Nigerian Economic Summit Group. And at NESG, all we do is in the national interest. The opportunity presented itself, and the private sector leadership took aim. The second Nigerian Economic Summit looked particularly at the 1995 budget and the measures needed for its successful implementation. It also attempted to identify a structure that will enable all Nigerians to participate in the development of a long-term visioning document.
You can be adversarial if you like, but to what purpose? We are trying to persuade people not to do things in our own interest, but in the general interest.
There's a difference between being political and being adversarial. Yes, you should advocate as vigorously as you can, but I think for the work that it's doing and for the effectiveness of doing this kind of work, you need to be sometimes, I don't know that what non-political makes it, but apolitical. You need to look at things, you need to be independent of political persuasions.
The economic, the first one came really to set an agenda that will bring out bring Nigeria out of the economic quagmire it was in and seek to improve the life of Nigerians. So much so that really the report of that summit was tagged economic action agenda, and in it were strategies to get the country out. Unfortunately, even though Chief Shonekan transformed from the chairman of the transition ruling council to the head of the interim government, he did not stay long enough to actualize the action plan that was drawn up by the first summit. So he left, Abacha took over, and that was that. Everything was put in the cooler.
The military was not quite geared up for that kind of dialogue. And the military was about making decrees. It was about, you know, ruling by fiat. And that sort of got a little bit in the way at the initial stages.
Alhaji Aminu Sale, of blessed memory, who was the Minister of Finance when the Transitional Ruling Council was on, became the secretary to the government and he became my boss. So it was easy when the private sector people came to see for the revival of the economic sector. It was a very simple thing to convince him, because the secretary of government was the pivot around whom all government activities were revolved. Now, he sold the idea to the then head of state, General Abacha, and who gave not only the go-ahead, but all the logistic support required. And as the permanent secretary of economic affairs, I was the principal public sector coordinator of government participation to the summit. And that was how the second summit was held in 1995.
We had done a phenomenal amount of work with the government of the day back in 1996 to develop the Vision 2010 document. And because that document was seen in certain quarters as a document that was actually formulated under the leadership of General Abacha, the succeeding government, which was the Obasanjo government, decided to just completely jettison it, which is a pity. Because the body of ideas and knowledge and the recommendations contained in that document are independent of any one person. It's a very good document, a tablet, a capsule, if you like, that was actually going to launch this country, you know, into the stratosphere if it was implemented with precision and effectiveness. So that was my single largest regret.